When it comes to being in prison, everybody cannot wait for that day they get out. That first day means so much. It's a memory that you will remember forever. Y'all sit back and enjoy the video of what I did on my first day out.
Hold down, man. Suitcase this. My cell phone and my charger don't walk with a limp. Get it knocked off or missing, you gon' get it. Next time I see you, you gon' leave airlift.
What's up, y'all? Welcome back to K-Fraud TV, man. Y'all go ahead and hit that notification bell button and make sure you hit that like and subscribe so you can see it first. All right, so I've been telling people, you know, I'm going to go ahead and drop a video on my first day home from prison. All right, so, you know, I'm going to break it down and let y'all know, you know, for anyone that's been to prison, knows what I'm saying is true. And for anyone who hasn't been there, you know, this is basically like the insight, you know, of how it would go. All right, now, for the most part, it don't matter if you have a year and a day up the road or if you have 15 to 20 years. You are gonna change your mind 1,000 times, you know, to what you're gonna do when you come home from prison. Your first day out, oh, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that. Man, I can't wait, this is what I'm gonna do. You're gonna tell so many people so many different stories of what it is you're gonna do. And it doesn't matter if you have it set in your mind of what you're gonna do all the way until the day you go home. You still might not do what you say you were going to do when you first get out. Oh, when I first get out, this is what I'm going to eat. You know, you literally, a lot of people say, oh, when I first get out, this is the thing I'm going to eat first. This and that, blah, blah, blah. You know, me personally, I used to send home tear outs out of magazines because I used to get subscription to all different magazines. OK, Us, Game Informers, The Food Network, Hip Hop Weekly, you know, all types of different things I used to get. So me, you know, a lot of people write down a list of things they want to eat. You start missing things. So you decide to write down what it is you want to eat when you get out. You might make up your own, you know, your own recipe and everything while you're in there. Write it all down. I did that plenty of times, lost the list, plenty of times made another one. Would just think of it and write to the list. The list got so long and so big that I just started grabbing pieces that are out of magazines that look like real good meals with recipes and stuff, and I would put it in an envelope and mail it to my mom, you know, because my mom, I know that's a place where it would touch down safely and wouldn't get lost, you know. So I always sent it home to her, and to this day, you know, I cook for my mom because she has cancer and everything, so I make her meals for the week. So, you know, to this day, she has a big old gallon Ziploc with all the pieces of paper ripped out of magazines in there, recipes that I sent her when I was incarcerated. So I literally can go in there and pull something out that we never had and be like, what about this? You want me to make you this? And then I go to the store and buy everything and come back and cook it for her. You know, you're gonna change your mind 101 times of what it is that you're gonna eat when you first came home, you know? But when I came home, the first thing I decided to eat is, you know, I went and got me a good old plate. Here they go, first plate out the chain gang. Y'all know what time it is. You know what I'm saying? That's real now. Everywhere we go, we eat steak. Excuse me, and chicken.
That wasn't until the end of the night. You see what I'm saying? Now, what I did when I first came home, though, is I went to the tattoo parlor and I had got my collarbone re-hit. It was already done in red when I was in prison, but I wanted to re-hit it again. So by the time I made it from DeSoto Annex, because that's where I EOS'd from, that's where the end of my sentence was. By the time I made it back down to Broward County, I went to the Fort Lauderdale Beach and I re-hit my tattoo. So within 5 hours of being home from prison, I was laying up under a tattoo gun. I said my whole time that I was gonna re-hit this because it looked darker in one spot and lighter in another. So I was like, yeah, I gotta re-hit it. So I actually went to a tattoo parlor, you know, laid up under the gun, got it re-hit and everything like that. And it was nothing. That's what I wanted to do. Everybody was blowing my phone up because they knew I was home. I went live on Facebook while I was, you know, in the car on my way back down. I went live and I was on my way to go get tatted. I first got out of prison, you know, I started saving my money just within the last year and a half while I was in there. I started saving all the money I made, everything I did. So I said this in recent videos before, I came home with a car, a truck, and over $10,000. Okay, and this was just saving my last year and a half. you know, not mentioning everything I done blew to have fun while I was in there. But I wanted to make sure I was straight when I came home from prison, so that way I wouldn't have to do nothing, you know, to put me back in harm's way to land in prison again. Because the first thing you do when you come home is what? You look for a job. If you don't get a job, or even if you get a job, say they fire you down the line or whatever, it gets harder and there's more pressure on your shoulders, it leads you back into the life of crime. So I wanted to make it to where I was straight for a while when I came home. When you're in prison, you don't have no responsibilities other than staying alive, you know, and shit like that. You don't have no responsibilities as far as bills. You don't have to pay rent. You don't have a water bill. You don't have an electricity bill. You don't have a car payment. You don't even have a cell phone bill. I had a cell phone bill, though, because I had jacks. You see what I'm saying? So when you hit the streets, it's all going to land on you. Now you have responsibilities again. So like I said, I remember being in confinement under investigation and was laying in confinement in the dark looking on Car Guru, was the name of the website that I was looking at cars and trucks. And I was literally laying in confinement doing my box time while looking up vehicles to buy, you know. And then that's how I ended up buying a car and a truck. You know, I bought the truck first, but then I didn't want the truck to be my everyday vehicle. So then I bought a car, you know what I'm saying? And the car was literally registered and sitting there 2 months before I even came home, because I didn't even have a license. You see what I'm saying? I didn't even have a license when I came home from prison. So my car was literally registered there, someone else's name, sitting there waiting for me to come home 2 months before I even got released. All right? I had got everything in rotation, did everything I had to do. Now, as far as, like, you know, the money-wise, you know, I made it to where, you know, I had $2,000 cash on me when I got released from prison. $2,000. I mean, my peoples bring me $2,000 out of my 10 and some change I had. They brought me $2,000. I'll never forget. That's when I first walked out of DeSoto. For those that have watched KFRAW TV Volume 1, you already know this was the introduction video. This is the first video I took when I stepped my feet outside them prison gates and was finally a free man. This was around the time that I was actually going live on Facebook, hanging out, enjoying my freedom. Even though it was only $2,000, it still felt like a lot to me, because it just felt good that I can have it and not worry about hiding it from the officers. Now I'm gonna show you what happened when I actually went to the corner store for the first time.
Take two singles if you got them. Y'all got Visine?
Clear Eyes?
Yeah, I need a thing of Clear Eyes.
And when I walked out of DeSoto, you know, they had some officers that had DOT, which was people that worked outside the gate. Well, I take that back. They weren't DOT. They were outside ground inmates. They were working as outside ground. So they were cutting grass and stuff in the parking lot, wash all the officers' cars that sit in the parking lot and shit like that. Those are the type of jobs they give people. They make you feel like it's a privilege being outside the gate. So wash our vehicles while we're in here working, watching y'all, you know, shit like that. And, literally, when I stepped out that gate, a bunch of them inmates were yelling, KFRAW TV, KFRAW TV. And, you know, I pulled out the $2,000 and I was like, man, y'all get your cash up, like this, to the officers that was out there. They're like, get back in the car, get in the car. And I'm like, oh, what you gonna do? Take my game time now? Take my game time now? And I started, you know, showing out towards the officer. I made it rain inside the parking lot. I threw it in the air, everything like that. All the money landed on the ground. I'm like, man, get your cash, I'll get you. I finally can run my mouth back to the officer fully, because boy, I'm already EOS. I'm out. You see, they can bring you back or give you a DR before you are literally released. You could be up there in the VP, the visitation part, you know, waiting to get, you know, your peoples are here to pick you up and everything, and them officers will test you, try to make you catch, you know, an infraction, a DR or something, before you actually go out that gate. Man, I made it out that gate. There wasn't nothing they could tell me. So I was like, man, get your cash up. I spread it on them. All the work squad was like, K-Frog TV, boy, K-Frog. All the boys were screaming for me and everything. I'm like, man, y'all keep y'all head up. Y'all already know. You know, shit like that. Now, after I got tatted, you know, I decided, you know, what I'm going to do from here is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go on a little shopping spree. So I'm going to, you know, I'm going to splurge a little piece for me and K-Frog Jr., my son. I didn't have him before I went to prison, like custody wise. But then once I got out, boom, he was mine already. I had that lined up while I was in prison. So boom, I got out, boom. So I'm going to go on a shopping spree for me and him. As soon as I was done getting tatted, you know, we went and we bought a bunch of shit.
For the fault niggas wanna know how a nigga made out today, nigga. Jay's on deck, nigga. You gotta do this, nigga. Griffey's on deck, nigga. You can pay for all JR, nigga. You do this shit, nigga. Got niggas playing everywhere, nigga. Fuck you mean, nigga. Got movies for the shorty, nigga. Pay for all Jr., nigga. Axe on deck, nigga, with a laptop. Nigga, tablet game, nigga. Griffey's over there, nigga. Xbox One game. Polo on deck, nigga. Polo, nigga. Cool on deck, nigga. Fuck you niggas got going on, nigga. Polo everywhere, nigga. Polo, cool water, nigga. Straight up, polo game, nigga. Fuck you niggas got going on, nigga. And this shit don't stop. Push me out.
You know, and it made him happy. You know, it wasn't even that much of a check. You know, it was just a little something. I went ham a little bit, but it was what it was. A lot of people thought my car was a rental. You know, they were like, because I pulled up in it the day I got out, they swore it was a rental car. You know, but then after a while, people started realizing it wasn't. It was really his car. You know, I'm the first one around my way that actually jumped out and did that. Everyone in my neighborhood still talks about that. I'm the only person they know that did that. You know, now, if I would have kept my mind on the money the whole bid, I would have came home with 5 times more than that. You know, but I didn't. I wasn't really thinking of saving up. I mean, I was thinking of saving up, but my goal was, when I get down to my last year, I'm gonna start saving up. So I did it a little early. When I got a little less than 2 years is when I started stacking, you know, but I was still spending money and everything, but I was still stacking at the same time. You feel me? So like I said, you're gonna change your mind 101 times. You're gonna say, oh, when I get out, man, the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go see these females. I'm gonna do this. I wanna go here. Man, I got out. I didn't know what the hell I wanted to do. I didn't know what to do. It felt so fake that I was finally out. The world felt like a different atmosphere. You know, I ended up going to the Hard Rock that night. You know, had two little females and shit like that or whatever. I went to the Hard Rock. You know, I went to some little place where it had like puncher machines and shit. We were there hitting the puncher machine, you know, shit like that. So I had met up with one little female or whatnot, you feel me? Hung out with a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Did our thing and shit. And then I decided to go to the Hard Rock.
Yeah. Damn, I look like a photo shoot. Look, got one on both sides. K-Frog, bitch. We out here, nigga. We thugging, nigga. What's up, man?
Hey, boy. Rent on block. 84B.
That real, nah. We both dot dog.
Oh, and through it all, you know, everybody had their hand out. Everybody was like, you know, trying to embrace me with open arms, but I didn't want to fall for it. You know, a lot of people weren't there for me throughout my bid, so I let them, you know, I let them kill themselves basically. Like, you good, you feel me? I'm glad you showed me how you was, you feel me? I'll dap it up. Yeah, what's happening? But we ain't gonna get no money together. We ain't gonna do nothing. I'm in my own lane, my own zone. You see, and that's how it's been ever since I came home. And I'm glad that I did it that way because I've made it this far. You feel me? I made it this far on my own and it's been working for me. So, you know, I didn't want to surround myself by everybody because one thing about it, when you come home, doesn't matter if it's your first, second, third, fourth, fifth bid, no matter when it is, it doesn't matter how much time you did, a little or a lot. Anytime you come home, you're going to have that glow to you. When you have that glow to you, so many people are going to want to be a part of your shine. You know, you're going to come home, whether you don't even do nothing, just by you being fresh out standing there, you have that shine and that glow to you that everyone's going to want to be a part of. You know, and you got to peep that. You got to peep people don't deserve to shine around you. They don't deserve to be a part of your shine. Even if they're not shining by being around you, just being a part of your shine. You got to learn and you got to understand that you deserve your shine. You did the time. You come home. You know what I'm saying? You hang out, man. You don't owe nobody nothing. Everybody's going to try to act like they're there for you just so they can have it in the back of their mind. Oh, when he came home, I put him on. Or when he came home, I blessed him with this. You know, when he came home, I gave him this to get him right so he could do all that, you know. So I didn't want that when I came home. I wanted it to where I had my own shit. So I ain't got to, you know, when someone, you know, no disrespect, but I don't need that. You good? That's simple. You ain't finna make it look like the person I am today is because of you. You know how many people would think, oh, the K-Frog is who he is right now because of them. See, so I wasn't going to let no one, you know, get that type of thought about me. So I wasn't accepting no handouts, you know. So, like I said, you would change your mind numerous times, you know. But the one thing I stuck by is I wanted to re-hit this across my neck in red. I got it done with skin candy, which was the kind of ink I had, red skin candy. The only person at Charlotte CI that actually had the red ink at the time, real street ink. And I got it done, so I wanted to re-hit it the day I got out. Also, I had it all set up, you know, for me to go into the studio, you know, for me to lay some tracks, you know, so I wanted to go in there and, you know, because of course I came home with a bunch of raps. Inside right now, I have a whole folder, a notebook folder with like 100-something songs from when I was in the juvenile program. Then I have a whole nother one from when I was in the county jail with 100-something songs in it. And then I have my 80-something songs left that I got when I came home from prison. I just never dropped them all yet, you know, but I got so much, you know, different songs and shit like that or whatever that, you know, I didn't follow all the way through it when I came home. But I did get out and go to the studio, but I only went for 4 hours. Not the same day I got out or nothing like that. Soon as I seen my baby mom, my first one, soon as I seen her, she was like begging me for money. I'm fresh out of prison. She's begging me for money. So I gave her some money, you know, here, whatever, you know, when it should have been the other way around, you know, like, man, let me hold something. You feel me? But, you know, I didn't rock like that. So for the most part, I just kicked back and I laid low, you know. But my advice to anyone watching this video, your first day out of prison, do not trust everybody. You never know what people's intentions are. You never know, you know, you've been gone a while. You don't know everything. Even though I was still plugged in and had my ears to the streets and was talking to people on the daily from in there, you don't know everything. You don't know who's beefing with who backstabbed who betrayed who. You don't know what female sleeping with who now. You know, there's so many different things that you're not gonna know because you was out of sight, out of mind. Okay, so just like when you get put in a new compound or in a new dorm, you know, you sit back and observe. Sit back and observe for a while, man, and you'll be all right. That's all I can basically tell you, man. Don't jump out head first. That's what everybody does, and that's where they mess up at. They jump out head first. They're so quick to get into the streets, get back hustling. Oh, I'm going to power up. I'm going to go ahead and cop me a 14 of this, and I'm going to start booming. I'm going to do this. Then I'm going to go get this. I'm going to go get that. I'm going to everything, you know. And then next thing you know, you're behind on time when you come home. You know, them females, when I was gone for 5, I came home. The females, the hustlers, the police, everybody is 5 years ahead of you. You're still in the time zone of when you got locked up. And you may not know it. You may not know it. If you got locked up in 2011 and came home in 2016, when you get out, everyone's moving in a 2016 pace. You're still in 2011. You don't know it yet because you're just now coming out. You know, people got kids that didn't have kids. People that were dating are no longer dating. You know, and people, now this person's dating this person. You know, like it's just, there's so much different. You got to just sit back and observe. And I promise you this. If you sit back and observe for a while, you can get into everything you want to get into. I'm not saying you never have to pick it up again or do it ever again. You know, you can definitely get back into it. Just sit back and observe first. You know, especially if you was in prison and you sat back and you observed and you wasn't, you know, and you were peeping all the realness and fake shit. Sit back and observe how it is on the streets when you first come home on your first day. Just sit back and observe, and you will see the vibes you once had with people. You're not going to look at them the same because you observed first. It's going to get you a long way better wise if you just observe before you just take action. Sit back and observe. That's simple, you know. And don't stress, you know, getting a job and all that. You know, your first week or two, man, you know, hang out, man. Don't even stress all the responsibilities and nothing. You deserve it. You've been gone. You know, hang out. That's like I did. You know what I'm saying? Hang out. Straight up, you know, like do your thing. You feel me? Me, it was cool because, you know, I had my own vehicle and everything set up for me when I came home, you know. And not a lot of people have that. But at the same time, you ain't gotta ask for no handouts. You know, you're gonna know what to accept and what not to accept. And then be wise enough to realize what to expect. Because like I said, same people that ain't sent you a letter or even answered your phone calls or anything in your 5 years or however long it is, when they see you, they gonna swear they your dogs. They gonna, man, what's up, dude? What you need? All that. You know, don't get me wrong, you know, coming from the streets, you know, street people don't write letters as often. You know, street niggas don't write letters as often. You feel me? To, you know what I'm saying? But if they don't acknowledge you, you feel me, while you're not there, you know what I'm saying? When you come home and it's your time to shine, you know, don't acknowledge them. That's how I look at it. Females that you didn't even know wanted to mess with you, or that didn't want to mess with you back in the past, are going to want to mess with you now because you have that glow. Females you used to mess with, you could still get. It's going to be that glow to where you're going to catch so much attention from people that you never even had the attention from before, to where when you get out, it's like a free chance, an opportunity to start with a different circle. That's simple. Like, you can literally get out and run back to the same circle if you want to. That ain't dead shit for you, you know, and that wasn't really there for you. 9 times out of 10, you'll land back up the road. Or you can sit back and observe, and then you won't even have interest in these people. And then you'll have interest somewhere else because you done got souped up a little bit from being locked up. And then you're going to observe more. And then you'll, next thing you know, you find yourself over here. Man, when you look at it 6-7 months down the road, man, I've been out 6-7 months. You look back, you don't hang out with no one you used to hang out before you went up the road. And that's basically how I did it. You know, me, I'm on, oh, shit. I mean, I got a couple, you know, I got people I pull up on, and then my dogs and shit till death and all that. But at the same time, I'm not in nobody's face at all. I am my team, you feel me? So, you know, you just sit back, man, and observe, man. You know, enjoy your first day out. Because I said this before in a video, it doesn't matter how long you've been locked up, long or short term, you always remember the first day you got out, and you always remember the day you got locked up. So you might as well make a memory of it. You know, that's simple, you know. Like me, I used to love to drink. E&J and all that shit, turn up, get crunk with my dogs and all that. As soon as I got out, man, everybody that, where I pulled up and everybody met up there, where everybody was at, they all brought bottles of E&J for me and all this shit, man. I let that shit sit there. I didn't even drink my first night out. I mean, not E&J. Later on that night, I went to the Hard Rock with some females. It was just being females. I went to the Hard Rock and shit, and I had me some rum and coke. You see what I'm saying? And, you know, like, you got to just sit back and observe, man, because you never know what you're getting yourself into. You never know who's being watched by the police. You never know what it is, you know. But for the most part, my first day out, it wasn't all that, but it's something I will always remember, because to me, I felt like I was on top of the world. You feel me? But anyways, man, y'all go ahead and hit that like, subscribe button. I appreciate y'all watching the video. You know, y'all keep y'all head up. Stay safe to this virus that's going on. And you already know, man, I'll see y'all next time, man. It's Frog.